So we are studying about cutting edge technologies, right? So in cutting edge technologies, we have five topics. Just we can look on it: augmented reality, virtual reality, artificial intelligence, internet of things, and finally big data analytics. So in the previous classes, we have completed the first four topics, and today we are going to study about the fifth topic, that is big data analytics. Okay, so we can go through it. So what is big data analytics? Do you have any idea? No? So just I'll explain you. So listen here. Now we do online shoppings frequently, right? So in online shopping, if you want to buy a sunglass, okay, you want to buy a sunglass, and for example, take Amazon website. So you'll go into the Amazon website and you will search for sunglasses. How many sunglasses you will get? Only one, two, three? No, right? Thousands of sunglasses you will get, right? So how you are getting that? Because of some applications called big data analytics. So what is the use of this big data? So first we can see what is big data. What is big? Big means large volume or complex things, right? So big data means same thing. You have large volume of complex data. You cannot process it regularly. For example, listen here. In a school, we are having some thousands of students, right? So if all the students' data are kept simply in a room without arranging, can you take the data easily? No, right? So for example, listen, all the data are dumped in a room. So you want to take your data. So you are going to the office and asking about your data. So if all the files are dumped, means can you take? It is very difficult to search, right? So what they will do? They will keep everything separately. So they'll take 8th grade separately, and in the 8th grade they will arrange a section A, B. In that section A, B, they will arrange your names in alphabetical order and they'll keep the files, right? So that we can take the data very easily. So same thing, big data analytics means you will have large data, large complex data, and using some data processing applications you are taking it. Okay, so listen, this is the definition for big data analytics. So big data analytics is the process of examining big data to analyze market trends, understand customer preferences and other useful informations. Okay, so we are going to study about what are the futures of big data analytics. Okay, so we have three futures. So keep in mind, big data analytics, it has three futures. The first future is volume. What is volume? Amount, right? Volume means amount. So you can handle large volume of data. This is the first future in big data analytics using that. So you can handle billions of data. This is the first one. Then second future is velocity. So for example, listen, you are searching for sunglasses, and if you have a good network facility, means if you are searching for sunglasses, you will get the result within a fraction of second, right? So or else it takes 2 or 3 hours to give you the result? No, within a fraction of seconds, you will get a large amount of results, right? So this is velocity. The speed is process of, the speed is extremely fast. Okay, the third one is variety. You can search any types of data. Okay, you can type text, you can type audio, you can type video. Okay, for example, now you all used to play games, right? So if you want to search a video based on a game, means just you will give the title, right? The game, and you will search. So you will get thousands of videos. Similarly, if you, while you are studying, you will get a doubt. So you will go to Google and you will type a word. So you will get thousands of definitions and thousands of explanations based on that word, right? So you can, this big data analytics can use varieties of data. So the data can be text or image also. If you want to stitch a dress, so you will just search a sample dress. So you will get thousands of dresses, right? So the data can be a image or a text or a video. So what are the three features of big data analytics? Volume, velocity and variety. Volume means it can handle large volume of data at a time. Velocity means if you are searching anything, you will get the result within a fraction of second. So the speed, velocity means the speed. The speed is extremely fast. And the third one is variety. So you can use different types of data to process. Okay, so this features of big data analytics, we can call it as three V's. Three V's means V's. First V is volume, second V is velocity, and the third V is variety. So you can call this big data analytics as three V's of big data analytics. So you can get a question like this: what are the three V's of big data analytics? So what are they? Volume, velocity, variety. Okay, so next we can study about what are the advantages of big data analytics. So the first advantage is improved customer service. Okay, so improved customer service. The second one is better performance analysis. The next one is better management of large amount of data. You can manage a large amount of data. So first one, improved customer service means, so listen here, in Amazon website, if you are searching for some things, maybe iPhones, often you are searching for phones or iPhones like this, means you will get suggestions about new phones in your account, right? So improved customer service means based on the customer's wish, they will provide you the service. The next one is better management of large amount of data. You can manage large amount of data at a time. The next one is identification of risk or fraud. Okay, you can easily identify the frauds. Okay, the next, applications of big data analytics. So where we are applying it. Okay, so the first one is, if you are searching for a result, you can get the result in a fraction of second. This is the first application, get the searched results in a fraction of second. Then the next application is, so while you are searching for a product, you will get similar products, right? Yes or no? So for example, listen, you are searching for some mobile cover. Okay, so you are searching your mobile cover, you are giving the name of your mobile and searching mobile cover. Only one or two products you will get? No. So for your phone, many covers, many similar products will be there, right? So you can get similar products when searching a product. So this is the second application. Then the third application means, so listen here, you are tagging some friends in social media. So I think all are using this Facebook and Instagram and all you are using, right? So you are uploading some photos in social media. In your Instagram story, you are uploading some photos and you are tagging some friends. In that photo, you are tagging some friends and you will get some suggestions, right? Some friend suggestion you will get. Okay, so this is because of big data analytics. Okay, you will get suggestions to tag friends in social media. Then games also. So for example, while you are getting high score, it will give some notifications, right? So while you are playing with your friends, if you are getting high score, means it will notify you are in first place and that person, your friend, is in second place and your friend's friend is in third place. Like that, it will give some score ratings, right? So in games also, they are using big data analytics. Okay, then the next one is comparing price. Okay, so for example, if you want to, in your home, they want to buy a television. You are getting the television in some Websites, okay, some online shopping websites, you are getting that television. So you will go only in only one website and get the televisions? No. So some price comparing websites will be there. You can go to the price comparing websites and you can collect the informations, right? So these are the applications of big data analytics. So first one is get the search result in a fraction of second. Second one is get similar products when searching a product. Third one is getting suggestions to tag friends in social media. Fourth one is games, and fifth one is comparing price. Okay, so we can move on to the next slide. Sorry, one more summer or applications are there. Used to find best routes to ship. So while we are ordering something through online shopping, that persons will deliver the product to your home, right? So they will use some softwares to find the best route. If they are picking the product from Nagarkoil, they want to take, for example, they want to deliver the product in Karangal. So they will check which one is the best route. So which one is the best route they will select, and they will travel in that route. Okay, so it is used to find best routes. So these are the applications. The next, we can revise the portions in this. So we have completed that lesson, and now just we can revise the topics which we have completed earlier. So first one is augmented reality, right? So what is augmented reality? So it is some computer generated content. So that computer generated content you are adding to the real world, right? So for example, we have in the previous videos I have shown some examples to you, right? So if you have seen that video, you may have understood what is augmented reality. So in a space, you will keep a furniture image, and you'll check if that furniture suits to a room like that. Okay, so this is augmented reality. So we have studied there are four types of augmented reality, right? So what are they? Do you remember what are the four types of augmented reality? So the first one is markerless. The second one is marker based. The third one is projection based. And the fourth one is superimposition based augmented realities. Okay, so just go through a book. What is markerless? What is marker based, what is projection based, and what is superimposition based. Okay, the next topic we have studied is virtual reality. Virtual reality, how it works? So you may have gone to planetariums. So can you see with your real eyes that? No, right? So you can't see anything. So to see the image virtually, what you'll do, you'll keep a special head mounted display or a different glass in your eyes, right? So it works by blocking out the user's vision. So it blocks our vision, and we can only see the things using some another head mounted display or another some devices. So this is virtual reality. Then machine learning, there is artificial intelligence. So to create RoboCentral, so it studies the situation and act based on that situation, right? So if you are having a robo, means you will program. So morning it wants to cook, and evening it wants to make some dinner, like that. If you are programming, means based on the situation it will act. Okay, so this is machine learning. Then last, Internet of Things, we have studied about it. So now we can see about some application based questions. So the first question is, Sanya's sister wanted to buy a new pair of sunglasses, but she did not have the time to go to a store. Sanya suggested a few websites where she could try on sunglasses sitting at home without having to go to the store. Which technology is being used by these websites? Okay, so read the question once and now tell me the answer. So I'll explain the question. Sanya's sister want to buy a pair of sunglasses. One girl wants to buy a pair of sunglasses. So, but she don't have time to go to the store to buy it. So she wants to sit at her home and wants to buy it. So Sanya is suggesting some website that you can sit in your home and you can try. Which technology you can use? Yes, augmented reality, right? So augmented reality means, so for example, we have studied some, I have shown some videos based on watches, right? So simple, a watch will be displayed. So you can keep your hand there so that watch will fix in your hand. Okay, so you can check whether it fits to your hand or not. So similarly, if you are buying sunglasses, means some websites will provide you this option. So you can sit in your home and they will, based on the augmented reality techniques, you want to use that some applications, augmented reality applications you want to use. So based on that applications, they will show you some samples from their store and you can sit in your home and you can try whether it fits in your face or not. Okay, so this first one is augmented reality. Then second one is Ramesh wanted to purchase a new mobile phone. He checked and compared the prices of the phone that he wanted as sold by sellers on a price comparison website. Which technology is used here? Which technology is used to compare the prices? Yes, big data analysis, right? Then the third question. Recently, a robot was developed by a Hong Kong-based company. It would speak to people, answer questions, and hold simple conversations. Which technology is used in creating this robot? To create robots, which technique is used? Artificial intelligence, right? So we have completed this lesson. So next class we can start up with a new lesson. So this lesson question and answers I'll send you through a PDF. So please mark the 1 mark questions in your book and please write the 2 mark questions in your booklet. Okay, so hope we can meet up on the next class. Till then, bye, take care. Thank you.